Oh. Whoa, my God. Holy moly, I'm being assassinated. Whoa.
No shit. Teleportation will commence in 3 seconds. Don't move. Supporters teleport instantly. And here I am in the spawn with Gunny Rabbit. And lots of books for sale. Super Snake Edda wrote a book and you can buy it. And Gunny Rabbit is trying to kill me. Or dance or something, I'm not sure. So the west is PvP and the east is non-PvP. Don't be too afraid of the west because, it's not everybody going around killing everybody there. You can if you want to. And there's an ender chest, which I can open. Yay, because I'm a member. Once you're a member, you can do stuff. And when you're not, you get this red message. You don't have permission for this area. Yes, everything's protected in the spawn area for 100 blocks or so. This book contains information a player would need to know whilst playing on the Wooden Axe Adults Only server. Woohoo! It's the Wooden Axe Law. No briefing, of course. No client mods. No advertising. Don't have AFK for too long. And to join, just go to woodenaxe.com, sign up on our forums, blah blah blah. And you can see other applications there. Fill out an application, fairly simple, just tell a little bit about yourself. And then wait a couple days and you should get a response in a couple of days or so. Might get a response right away, even. Just never know. And I'm being shot at with flaming arrows. But he's not a very good shot, so no worries. And I found a chicken place. What kind of chicken is this? Hey, Pooterific, join the game. Okay, this area is no spawn zone for animals. Imagine chicks on each level as they move down, they age. Type something. And you can click on the sign here and get 64 cooked chicken. B5, I think that's the cost, is B5. And they have a price system worked out. And you can read about that in the wiki, but everybody gets $100 when they first join, and you can sell different items to make money. I don't think chicken is in demand, but there should be. Maybe on the wiki you can find out what is in demand, if anything. Not sure. I'm kind of new myself, and what I like is looking at the builds. You can go around this whole area and see the protected spawn and see all the amazing builds. I think it's quite amazing, really.
Multiplayer. Today I want to tell you about the server called Wooden Axe. WorldWoodenAxe.com. I don't know what the difference is. Same thing. I just accidentally loaded it twice. But before I go there, I want to show you a Google search for Wooden Axe Minecraft for adults. 18 plus, only gray listed Minecraft server, long running stable adults only server. It's a really nice server. You can go to new member introductions, rules and facts, the map, and the forums. And so you apply in new member introductions, people putting their application in there, and you can, I can usually find mine, must be on the next page. Said, hello Woods Peoples, here I am. So you can check out my application. Oh, something happened. Yes, and then you'll get a welcome aboard a day or two or three later, depending if they have time. But ain't nobody got time for that. People don't like videos, some people, but I love videos. That's okay, whatever. Everybody's different. And here's the Wooden Axe live map. Trying to click on things. Okay. I have a couple different world types. There's the world. And this shows what time of day it is. I just noticed that today. So I guess it's a 24-hour clock happening. So here's the world map. And then there's the nether map and the end map. There was somebody here in the end. You must have something going on there. I haven't checked those things out yet. This is a huge map. Well, it's limited by this red border up here. And you can follow different players around. Here's Ankit Aknaja. He's from, I read his biopsy, or his application. He's from Alaska. And there's Polar Bear Tom. And there's EP43. Now you can zoom in on these people and see what's going on. See where they are. Or you can zoom in on yourself, see where you are. Chase a friend around the map. Try and catch a friend. I delivered him a piece of chicken because he said KFC was out of chicken. Took me an hour to catch him. Just about. Yeah. So, can be hard. And he's like, what are you chasing me for? But it's nice to zoom in. And you spawn in at spawn, and you can't break any blocks around spawn. There's lots of cool stuff to look at, some really nice buildings, amazing buildings. And over here is the Eiffel Tower and KFC. And also there's a farm right around here where you can pluck some food. Yeah, there I can tell by the pumpkins, and I did that in my video. As long as you replant, you can get some wheat or some potatoes and some watermelon. Yeah. I'm gonna zoom out a bit. See if I can find my place. Deep Finger is a neighbor, so I could try zooming in on him, see where he is. He's not in that area. I'm somewhere over by the red line. Here's the red line. And have to look for some snow-capped mountains. Wait, I think it's up this way. I'm zoomed out all the way. And yeah, it's actually a fairly big map. Okay. Can find my way around by this block of coal. I'm right in this area. And I just built my first little mushroom. So there's me. And I've only been on here a couple of times. over the last week and built this little tower and a little farm. Got some potatoes here. If you visit the server, you can help yourself to my potatoes, and got some wheat here and another little farm in the back. It's kind of blocked by this mountain, but back in here, and got some cows and chickens started down there. Yeah, so there's a couple of neighbors. You can see your neighbors. Deep Finger just built this new bridge here, and last time I was on, this was just a base, a white base, and he just totally built up this house. And these are friendly people in this neighborhood, although we are on the PvP side here. Everything, I think this is the west. Oh, here's a east-west thing. So everything to the west is player versus player, and everything to the east is non-player, non-PvP. So no fighting in the east, but in the west you can kill people. I think you're obliged to give their stuff back, but I'm not sure exactly. So you want to read the rules. Well, there's another neighbor, Exile 500. I have not met them yet. But I'm sure they'll be friendly. I sure hope so. So it's a very popular place. And I think that's all I want to show you about the map. But wow, this map is so handy. I'm going to go log on. If I can figure this out. How to bring up Minecraft. It's hidden behind this. Here it is. Minecraft. Wooden axe. Join server. So, Shrooms just joined the game, and I'm over by the Eiffel Tower, which is near KFC. And it's night. Yeah, so I just came on here with nothing and picked up some crops really quickly, and somebody came along and threw me a pumpkin pie and a leather tunic with protection, some feather falling boots. Oh my, that's so awesome. And that was the rabbit guy who's in my last video. Rabbit something. So, I'll have to get his name. Anyways, yeah, that was awfully neighborly. Oh yes, so you can go up the tower here. And I just wanted to show you guys the map. That I'm on the map. It should have updated and put me on here. Yep, there I am. Shrooms 333. Go there, and KFC is fairly close to spawn. Oh, Eiffel Tower. Fairly close to spawn. So, it's just down the road to the friendly side, the east. Yes. Just head straight east. If you're hungry, grab some food right at that farm. You can also buy food at KFC. You may have to hang out there and wait a little bit for the chicken to cook, but it's a good way to get started. You can get like 64 chicken. You're not supposed to break any blocks that's a person on a person's property. So, yes, you have to get away from spawn, basically. And it's very populated in this area. for a long ways. So you want to come like way out here, you're going east. And there is a rail cart system, which is fantastic. I'm going to show you guys that. But I do have to get some iron. Like 2, 3, 4, 5 pieces of iron to make a rail cart. And so I'm going to try and do that. And be right back. See you later.
Okay, awesome. We are here at Rocket Tam. Oh, I sent a request to Rocket Tam. She's, yeah. Well, no, I sent a request asking for arrows, and Rocket Tam said, yeah, I have arrows. Just teleport to my place. And she sent me a teleport request. I accepted the request with the command, I think it's /tp accept. And she just gave me a whole bunch of arrows. What a nice girl. And someone else was calling her a devil. I don't think she's a devil. She's awesome. And yeah, so I've met a lot of people on the server. Just wandering around, you run into people and you can talk to them in the chat just by typing stuff. You have to remember to push T every time before you type. And you can have a private conversation. There are codes for that. You can just look up the simple codes, type out the simple code, and when somebody invites you to have a private chat, you accept their request, and then you type /r to reply to them every time you want to reply. And I hope I got that all straight. Anybody please comment or correct me if I'm wrong. And gee, Rocket Tam has a lot of stuff. And a lot of people are well established on this server. They have a lot of stuff. And that's like one of the big things I like about this server, is you can wander around, meet new people, and see some like really amazing things that they built. So it's great for getting ideas. If you want to build something amazing, it's great to be able to see how other amazing things look and how they work, and walk all around and try and get a tour of the different places. Some residences are private, but there's a lot of public ones. And this is one called Diamond. Well, this is actually the arena, and right next door to it is Diamond. And Deepfinger is sending me a request. Yeah, so I accepted his request. And yeah, that's another thing you can do, is teleport to somebody. You send them a request. And I think it's TP, something like that. TP, and you type out their name. /TP. Yes, you better look that up. I don't have them open right now. And I should look them up. I'm gonna look them up and add that in here. Deepfinger is showing me how the arena works. There's a lot of buttons and it's really cool. yeah, so underneath this arena there's a bunch of spawners. And you can control the flow of monsters by using the switches. You can build up the monsters down below. They come rising up into the four corners of the room. And there's doors, so you can close the doors and lock all the pigmen into this one room. And there's another one spawning zombies, and another one spawning spiders. And if you come here and play,
You can get a bunch of spider string and zombie flesh and golden swords and stuff. And feathers. I don't know why she has feathers. Today she's giving away some diamond armor. Miss Mijo. All this full set of diamond gear. And I don't think she does this every day. But, you know, a lot of stuff is just being in the right place at the right time. But she usually has a bunch of these golden swords and stuff, which is awesome too. She did give me a whole bunch of diamond gear, which was awesome, until I got zombinated by too many zombies and I lost it on the floor of the arena. And underneath the arena, it's full of hoppers and chests and stuff. So when you drop your gear on the arena floor, it kind of gets sucked up by these hoppers. And I haven't figured out where it goes. Somewhere underneath, I don't know. I thought it would be coming back up to those chests, but it probably takes a while to work its way through the system or something like that. I don't know. Anyways, these zombies can get pretty intense. And wow. This is like, I haven't played too many arena type things. I never played one like this before. And I thought, you know, it would just be silly trying to fight a bunch of zombies in a fake arena, but it's not silly. It's fun. It is so much fun. And you can turn the buffs on and off. When you have the buffs on, you have a great chance of actually beating all these guys because your health regenerates really fast. But when the buffs are off, it's a whole different game, and I wasn't ready for that, and that's why I died. That's my excuse, and I'm sticking with it. Well, you come here and try it. And yes, Miss Mijo would be very happy to see people here. Keeping the place activated. If nobody's here, then nothing will be active. And this is just one of the many active places on the server. Yes, and so I think I said enough, and hopefully I explained everything right. Let me know if I explained anything wrong. Correct me, please. If you can explain things better, that would be awesome too. I will link any videos that explain things better or give a different take on stuff. So, any other YouTubers out there, I will link, I'd be happy to link anything you guys have. Anyways, thanks for watching. And this is the upper level. It's so cool with this ice. I love it. I love the all the flower decoration and creative decoration ideas all the way around this arena. It's well worth coming here, just running around, taking a look. You even have donkeys. Yeah, real donkeys. You can actually ride this donkey. I was a little surprised. But funny thing is, riding a donkey on ice, kind of derpy. It moves in a funny way. I don't know if that's with all donkeys or just when they're on ice. Anyways, I've said enough. And I think there's audio to cover everything else. So later. Just want to say thanks for watching this whole video. If you made it to the end, all right. Thanks a lot. And it does take a lot of work to put together. So please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel, and I'll be able to do many more videos, hopefully. And see y'all on the flip side. Later.